Hello students, so in this video we're going to discuss the summary of fundamental unit of life chapter. Here we're going to discuss about cell organelles and what is structure and how does it function. So this will be the summary of all the cell organelle which is present in the cell. Cell membrane, a double membrane composed of lipid and protein, so present both in plant and animal cell. Function, it provides shape and protect the inner organelle of the cell and act as a selectively permeable membrane. Next one is centrosome. So centrosome is an cell organelle which is present in animal cell, composed of centriole and found only in the animal cell. It plays a major role in organizing the microtubule and cell division. Next, our cell organelle will be chloroplast, present only in plant cell and contains a chlorophyll pigment which gives a pale green color pigment to the cells and function site of photosynthesis. Cytoplasm, a jelly-like substance which consists of water, dissolved nutrient and waste product of the cell. Function, responsible for the cell metabolic activities. Endoplasmic reticulum, a network of membranous tubule present within the cytoplasm of a cell. Function, it forms the skeletal framework of the cell, involved in detoxification, production of lipid and protein. Golgi apparatus, membrane-bound sac-like organelle present within the cytoplasm of the eukaryotic cell. It is mainly involved in secretion and intracellular transport. Next is lysosomes, a tiny circular-shaped single membrane-bound organelle filled with digestive enzyme. The function of this lysosome is, it helps in the digestion and remove waste and digest dead and damaged cell. Therefore, it is also called as suicidal bugs. Mitochondria, an oval-shaped membrane-bound organelle, it also called as the powerhouse of the cell. The function, it is the main site of cellular respiration and also involved in store energy in the form of ATP, adenosine triphosphate molecules. Next, nucleus, a largest double membrane bound organelle which contains all the cell's genetic information. So it controls all the activity of the cells and helps in cell division and control the aridity. Peroxisomes, a membrane-bound cellular organelle present in which the cytoplasm, which contains the reducing enzyme, involved in metabolism of lipid and catabolism of long-chain fatty acid. And next one is plastid, double membrane-bound organelle, and there are three types of plastid. One is leucoplast, chromoplast and chloroplast, whereas leucoplast is colorless plastid. Chromoplast, which gives a brightly colored pigment to the plant, and like the colors involved are blue, red, yellow, are color plastids. Chloroplast, which contains a chlorophyll, which gives a green pigment to the plant. Function, it also helps in the process of photosynthesis and pollination, impart color for leaf, flowers and fruits, and stores starch, protein and fats. Ribosomes or ribosomes is up to your pronunciation. Non-membrane organelle found floating freely in the cell cytoplasm or embedded within the endoplasmic reticulum. So here you can see the organelle endoplasmic reticulum are of two type. So one is rough endoplasmic reticulum and other one is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So how these are types which can be modified because of the ribosome which is present in the particular cell organelle. So ribosomes function involved in synthesis of protein. Vacuole, a membrane bound fluid filled organelle found within the cytoplasm. So vacuole is like the space occupier, okay. It provides shape and rigidity to the plant cell and helps in digestion, excretion and storage of substance. So these all about the cell organelles which is present in our chapter Fundamental Unit of Life. Let us discuss some questions. what would happen if the plasma membrane rupture or breaks down? So what happened? If ever the plasma membrane ruptures or breaks down, then the cell will not be able to exchange material from us surrounding by diffusion. So as a result of it, protoplasmic material will disappear and the cell will die. So this will be the answer for plasma membrane ruptures. Next question. What would happen to the life of a cell if there was no Golgi apparatus? Golgi apparatus perform the function of storage modification and packaging of product. If Golgi apparatus is not there, then the material synthesized by cell will not packaged and transported. Next, we discussed another one question in NCERT. Which organelle is known as the powerhouse of the cell? Of course, it's mitochondria. So mitochondria are known as the powerhouse of cells because energy required for various chemical activities needed to support life is released by mitochondria in the form of ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate molecules. Next, where do the lipid and protein constituting the cell membrane get synthesized? So the answer will be lipids are synthesized in smooth endoplasmic reticulum and the proteins are synthesized in rough endoplasmic reticulum. Okay. Why? Because rough endoplasmic reticulum? Because in rough endoplasmic reticulum, there is a presence of ribosomes. So ribosomes is the factory of protein synthesizer. Okay, ma. Thank you. We'll discuss some questions. All the living organisms are composed of fundamental unit called cell. Who discovered the nucleus in the cell? Robert Brown. Who saw the free living cells for the first time? Leeuwenhoek. Okay. Who discovered the cell? Robert Frost. Name two unicellular organisms. Amoeba, Chlamydomonas. Write two differences between prokaryote and eukaryote. Nuclear region and chromosomes. Okay, so this will be the difference between prokaryote and eukaryote. What are the two types of endoplasmic reticulum? So ER in short form of endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum and soft, that is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. What are the function of Golgi body? It includes the storage modification and package of cell product. The complex sugar are made from simple sugar in the Golgi apparatus. So these are the function of Golgi bodies.